Hello students, let's start with the chapter number 2, that is polynomial. So in polynomial class 9, you already have studied about the polynomial. So first we start with the standard form. Standard form is x to the power n a to the power n, sorry, a n plus x to the power n minus 1, then a n minus 1 plus dash dash, at last x to the power 3 a to the a 3 plus x square dot a2 plus x1 a1 plus x0 a0. This is the standard form of polynomial, or simply you can write down that px equal to 5x to the power 4, 5, then x to the power 4, after that x to the power 3, then x square, then x to the power 1, and then without x. So in this way we can write down the polynomial in standard form. Next topic is degree of the polynomial. So what is the degree of polynomial? The highest power of variable is called its degree. For example, we can see that in a polynomial px, polynomial in x, x to the power 4 plus x square plus 5x to the power 1. Here you can see that the highest power of variable, that is x, is 4. So degree is 4. In the next polynomial, py equal to y square plus 2y plus 5. Here you can see that the value, the highest power of y is 2. So we can write down the polynomial has degree 2 because the highest power of variable is 2. Now, type of polynomial. Yeah, already we have discussed in class 9th. Number 1, on the basis of terms. Or on the basis of degree, two type hai isko define karne ke. So we can define by two method. Number one, number of terms, and second, number of according to the degree. So first, monomial. Simple, a polynomial having only one term is called monomial, whatever degree is there, but we have to count only the terms. So in monomial only one terms is there. In binomial it has only two terms, any two terms. We are not trying to see the power. We will only count the number of terms, right? One and two terms, so it will be binomial. Now trinomial having three terms, 1, 2, 3, so it is trinomial. Next, quadrinomial, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if there are four terms in a polynomial, we'll call it quadrinomial. Next, on the basis of degree. So first polynomial is linear polynomial. A polynomial having degree 1 is called linear polynomial. So in this polynomial, x plus 5, so the highest power of variable is 1, so its degree is 1. Quadratic polynomial, a polynomial having degree 2 is called quadratic polynomial. Here we can see that 2x square plus 5x plus 3 having the highest power 2, so its degree is 2, so it will be a quadratic polynomial. Next, cubic polynomial having degree 3, x cube plus 2, x to the highest power of x is 3, so the degree is 3, so it will be known as cubic polynomial. Next, biquadratic polynomial, a polynomial having number of terms, whatever number of terms there, we have to count the degree. Here x to the power 4, x to the power 1, so highest power is 4, again the degree is 4, so it is biquadratic. So if degree is 1, linear. If degree is 2, quadratic. If degree is 3, cubic. And degree is 4, biquadratic. Next, constant polynomial and zero polynomial. Any constant number, px equal to 8 or px equal to root 5, lots of examples are there. In this type of polynomial, the degree of constant polynomial is 0. So the constant polynomial, a polynomial in which degree is 0. Next is zero polynomial, px equal to 0. That is the only one form, px equal to 0. This is called zero polynomial. Its degree is not defined. Its degree is not defined. So this is the type of polynomial on the basis of degree, on the basis of terms. Next. In class 10th, we'll discuss about the quadratic polynomial. This is the R syllabus topic, quadratic polynomial. Standard form, ax square plus bx plus c. Here you can see that a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant term. Graph, parabola, either upward or downward. It depends on the value of a. If a is positive, then upward. If a is negative, then downward. Number of zeros, its degree is 2, so there will be the highest power of x is 2, so that's why the value of x will be 2, or number of zeros will be 2. One is called alpha, another is called this beta. So there are 2 zeros in quadratic polynomial, alpha and beta. First formula, that is the relation between zeros and coefficient. Alpha and beta are the zeros. A, B, C are the coefficient. So this is the relationship between the zeros and coefficient. So alpha plus beta equal to minus B upon A, and alpha into beta equal to C upon A. A, you can take out the coefficient of x square, B coefficient of x, and C is the constant term. Sometimes alpha, beta are given and you have to form a polynomial whose zeros are given. So formula k x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta means sum of zeros and product of zeros. You have to write down. Here k is any real number. It can be 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2 by 3. Any number it can be, or rational, any real number. Now we'll discuss one question. Let alpha equal to 3, beta equal to 1 by 2. Then you have to find out a polynomial whose zeros are given 3 and 1 by 2. So the required polynomial is x square minus alpha plus beta into alpha into beta. So we have to put in place of alpha 3, in place of beta 1 by 2. Now here you can see that x square minus 3 plus 1 by 2 into x plus 3 into 1 by 2. After simplifying, 7 by 2x plus 3 by 2. Now taking LCM, so 2x square minus 7x plus 3 upon 2. And then 1 by 2 take out at outside the bracket. In bracket, 2x square minus 7x plus 3. That can be your answer. Or you can write down like this also. 2x square minus 7x plus 3. Okay? So this one is also right. And the previous answer is also right. Now, if a polynomial having degree 3 means the highest power of variable is 3. Here you can see that the highest power of x is 3, then 2, then 1, then 0. So the highest power is 3. So there will be degree 3 and number of zeros will be 3. One is alpha, another is beta, another is gamma. So 3 zeros we can take, alpha, beta, gamma. Like x square minus 3x plus 2, we have only 2 zeros, alpha and beta. But in cubic polynomial, we have alpha, beta and gamma. 3 polynomial, 3 zeros. So now we'll try the exercise 2.1 from your NCRT. Questions may be different because I am taking another questions. Maybe they can be common or maybe they are different. So you can try yourself. I am just giving the concept. You can try yourself. Definitely you will get the answer. In this polynomial, here is a polynomial Px. Px means polynomial in variable x. We have to find out after looking at the graphs. There are 4 images. You can look and you can find how many zeros are there of the given polynomial Px. It's very simple. How many times the graph is intersecting x-axis, you can count, and that will be your answer. Simple. Jitni bar x-axis ko graph cut kar raha hoga, utne hi uske zeros honge. Okay, let's check. In first image, it's intersecting x-axis at only one point. So number of zeros, 1. In second, graph, red line, it's not intersecting x-axis at any point. So number of zeros, 0. In third, you can see that 1, 2, 3. At 3 places, it is intersecting the x-axis. So number of zeros will be 3. And the last one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 places where it intersecting the x-axis. So number of zeros simply 5. So we can write down in the first question, number of zeros 1, second number of zeros 0, third 3, and the fourth is 5. So in first exercise, simply you can write down the answer. Next. Exercise 2.2. Here we can see that there are only 2 questions. One question having 5 and 6 parts. Second question is also having the same 4 and 5 parts. Okay. So I am just going to giving the concept. You can try yourself. Questions will be easily can be done. First question is find the zeros and verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. So simply he is asking first find the zeros and then verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. Relationship between zeros and coefficient, I told you before earlier, that was the formula, this one. Alpha plus beta minus of b upon a and alpha into beta c upon a. So now first polynomial is 2x square minus 5x plus 3. This is the first polynomial. So first you have to find out the zeros by splitting the middle term. So after splitting of middle term, I got x equal to 1 and x equal to 3 by 2. So x equal to 1 alpha and x equal to 3 by 2 we can take as beta. So two zeros alpha and beta, we got 1 and 3 by 2. Now first condition we have done, find the zeros. Now we have to verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. This is the relationship between zeros and coefficient. Alpha plus beta are zeros, b upon a, b and a are coefficient. So in place of alpha we can put 1, in place of beta we can put 3 by 2. So 1 plus 3 by 2, 5 by 2. Now see the right hand side, minus b upon a. Here a 2, b minus 5 and c 3. Agar hum isko compare karte hain standard form se, standard form is ax square plus bx plus c. So a coefficient of x square 2, b coefficient of x and c constant term. So in place of b, minus ka sign aap bahar rakhiye, and in bracket write down the value of b. So the value of b is minus 5. So minus minus plus 5, or a is 2. A is 2, b is minus 5. So minus 5 upon 2, 5 upon 2, left side and right side equal, so it is verified. Now see the product one. Alpha into beta equal to c upon a. Alpha 1, beta 3 by 2, multiply 3 by 2, c upon a, c 3, a 2, 3 by 2, left hand equal to right hand side. So first we have find out the zeros, then verify the relationship between the zeros. So first question mein, aapke paas jitne parts hai, sab mein yehi tarika hai. First you have to find out the zeros and then verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. Simple. One more question is there, t square minus 15. To find the zeros, first t square minus 15 equal to 0. T square minus 15 equal to 0. Then t square minus root 15 square is equal to 0. Then it will be t plus root 15, and another is t minus root 15 equal to 0. So t is equal to root 15 and minus root 15. These are the two zeros. Take out first as alpha, second as beta. Now verify. Alpha plus beta equal to minus b upon a, root 15 plus minus root 15 equal to 0. Here minus in place of b, a 1, t square ke baad t nahi hai, to yahan pe b ki value hogi 0 aur a ki value 1. So 0 upon 1, 0 equal to 0. This is verified. Now alpha into beta equal to c upon a. In place of alpha, root 15. In place of beta, minus root 15. And in place of c, minus 15. In place of a, 1. So minus 15 is equal to minus 15. It is also verified. So this is the question number 1. Now next question. Question number 2. In this question, sum and product of zeros given, and you have to form a polynomial. Polynomial ka formula hamare paas tha, x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha into beta. So we have to just put the value of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta in the polynomial. Here you can see that first is the sum, second is the product. So direct you can put the values. x square minus, in place of sum we can put root 2, then x plus, then alpha beta minus 6. So your polynomial will be x square minus root 2x minus 6. This is the answer. Now you can try next one. X square minus, in place of sum 1 by 2x, in place of product 1 by 2. Now taking LCM, so 2x square minus x plus 1 upon 2. This is the required polynomial. So in this way you can find out the polynomial and you can easily